Hello friends, welcome to my channel Botanical Studies. In this video we will discuss about rose cultivation. The discussion will go through following points: introduction of rose, floral decorations and floral arrangements with rose, climate and selection of site, soil preparation, important rose types, rose varieties, propagation, planting, irrigation, pruning, nutrition, weeding and hoeing, mulching, pinching, disbudding and disuckering, insect and pests of rose, diseases of rose, flower harvesting and post-harvest management, marketing of rose, and finally importance of rose. Introduction of rose. We all love roses, isn't it? Rose is a flower which glorifies love and beauty. Botanical name of the rose is Rosa alba. Rose belonging to family Rosaceae, and it was originated in China. Rose is the most important cut flower and ornamental plant in a garden. It is the number one cut flower in the international market. For cut flowers, roses are extensively cultivated in the Netherlands, Colombia, Japan, France, United States of America, Morocco, Korea, and Israel. In the flower market, mainly hybrid tea and floribunda types are in demand for the production of cut roses. In India, it is grown under greenhouse for cut flower purpose, and large number of varieties are grown for the garden purpose, also for production of rose oil, rose water, gulkand, etc. Floral decorations with rose. Rose is an exotic ornamental flower plant. Rose flowers are mainly used for decorating conference halls, houses, palaces, hotels, in parties, functions, and in wedding ceremony. It is also used for the preparation of floral rangoli and for aquarium decorations. Flowers are also used to prepare bouquets. These are the some attractive rose flower bouquets used in various functions because these flowers are long-lasting and also remain fresh for longer period. Rose flowers are available with different colors: red, pink, yellow, orange, and white. Climate and selection of site. Let us now see the climatic conditions and selection of site for the rose cultivation. Roses can be grown successfully under various climatic conditions. Quality flowers are obtained in areas with bright sunny days, cool nights, moderate humidity, and absence of strong winds. In general, it prefers day temperature of 25 to 30 degrees Celsius and night temperature of 15 to 16 degrees Celsius. Long days of 12 hours and humidity of 60 to 70 degree favors growth and quality flower production. Selection of site is very important for the successful growing of roses. The selected site for rose planting should get full day sunlight. In summer season, it prefers partial shade during the hot afternoons. In the garden rose, plantation area should not be too close to tall trees. It do not prefers waterlogging conditions even for a short period. The location of the rose plantation should be free from dust. Soil. Rose plants grow well in medium loamy, rich in organic matter, well-drained soil of at least 40 to 50 centimeter depth. The subsoil must have the capacity to hold and retain adequate moisture. Clayey soil, which are heavy and poor in aeration, are not be preferred by rose plant. In case of clay soil, it is advised to mix sand and well decomposed farmyard manure to make it porous. The base soil pH for roses should be 5.5 to 6.5 with an electrical conductivity of less than 1. Nowadays, artificial media like cocopeat, perlite, and a mixture of cocopeat and perlite are preferred because they are inert, sterile, and have no cation exchange capacity, so that applied nutrients are available to the rose plant directly. Roses fall into the sensitive category of the plant with respect to salinity tolerance. Budded plants have less tolerance to adverse conditions of soil and climate than plants raised from cuttings. Soil preparation. Roses are perennial plants and will remain in the same bed for many years. The initial preparation of the soil should preferably start during the summer season. Before bed preparation, mix the basal doses of fully decomposed dry farmyard manure at 6 to 8 kg per square meter, and quantity of inorganic fertilizer is depend upon the fertility of the soil. In termite-prone areas, anti-termite chemicals like chlorpyrifos should be applied to the soil before planting. Rectangular 30 cm raised beds with 40 to 50 cm wide path between two beds offer certain advantage for cultural operations. The width of the bed should be 1 meter and the length of the bed should be depends upon the dimension of the polyhouse. In the rectangular bed, planting two rows will be a good practice. Average plant population varies from 7 to 9 plants per square meter. Important types of rose flowers. There are many types of rose flowers. Here we will discuss some of the important types. Climbing roses. They are the well adapted to grow along fences and trellis. Example, Altissimo, Blaze, Dortmund, etc. Floribunda roses. Floribunda roses are shrubs that have upright or bushy branching habits. Example, Iceberg, Julia Child, Tickled Pink, etc. David Austin roses. David Austin roses, also known as English roses. Example, Princess Alexandra of Kent, Lady Emma Hamilton, Graham Thomas, etc. Grandiflora roses. These roses are crossed between hybrid tea roses and floribunda roses, offering the dainty flowers of hybrid tea blooms and the long blooming periods of floribundas. Example, Cherry Perfect, Mother of Pearl, Queen Elizabeth. Hybrid tea roses. These are high maintenance roses, which preferably the most beautiful of all the modern garden roses. Example, Dark Night, Eternal Flame, Double Delight, etc. Ground cover roses. These roses have spreading of trailing habits, typically being wider than tall. Example, Flower Carpet Coral, Flower Carpet Scarlet, Flower Carpet Amber, etc. Polyantha roses. These roses are popular because they are easy to care and have a long blooming period. Example, the Fairy, Grusan, Aken, etc. Rambler roses. These roses have a similar climbing habit to climbing roses, being suitable for training up fences or along pergolas. Example, American Pillar, Dorothy Perkins, etc. Shrub roses. Shrub roses are typically hardy and easy care plants. They flower continuously with small flowers that blooms profusely. Example, Peachy Knockout, Double Knockout, etc. Miniature roses. They bloom for several weeks at a time with dainty stems, foliage, and flowers. Example, Lemon Delight. Alba roses. Alba roses are some of the oldest roses in existence and also present some of the hardest rose available. Example, Pompan, Blanc, Perfect. Bourbon roses. These roses were first introduced in France in 1817 and they are suspected to be crossed between China roses and Damask roses. Example, Madame Isaac, Perrier, Zepherin, Drohin, etc. China roses. These roses tend to be resistant to diseases, but they are tender and well susceptible to cold weather conditions. Example, Louis Philippe. Centifolia roses. These are also known as cabbage roses because the petals are packed together so tightly. Example, Petite de Hollande, Rose de Missec. Damask roses. Damask roses have a romantic appeal. Example, Duke de Cambridge. Moss roses. These roses blooms once each year with fragrant bloom available in wide selection of color. Example, Portulaca grandifolia, Crested Moss, etc. Rose varieties. These are the rose varieties which are cultivated for various purposes. Commercial varieties like पिंक पुसा गौरव, रेड सुपरस्टार, मॉन्टेजुमा, मर्सिडीज, पुसा प्रिया एंड फर्स्ट रेड. बेडिंग व्हरायटीज लाईक पिंक पुसा गौरव, रेड मॉन्टेजुआ, सुपरस्टार, क्रिश्चियन डायोर, ओक्लाहोमा, हॅपीनेस, पुसा बहादूर. एक्झिबिशन व्हरायटीज लाईक फर्स्ट प्राईज, आयफेल टॉवर, पुसा सोनिया, रेड क्रिम्सन डायोर, मॉन्टेजुमा, सुपरस्टार. अँड सेंटेड व्हरायटीज लाईक क्रिम्सन ग्लोरी, ला फ्रान्स, सुगंधा. प्रोपोगेशन. रोज इज प्रोपोगेटेड बाय सीड्स, बडिंग, ग्राफ्टिंग, लेअरिंग, कटिंग अँड थ्रू मायक्रो प्रोपोगेशन फॉर डिसीज फ्री प्लांट. असेक्शुअल प्रोपोगेशन अलाउज प्लांट टू ग्रो ट्रू टू टाईप. इट इज कमर्शियली प्रोपोगेटेड बाय अ व्हेजिटेटिव्ह मेथड लाईक स्टेम कटिंग, बडिंग, स्टेंटिंग एक्सेट्रा. लेट अस डिस्कस द मेथड ऑफ व्हेजिटेटिव्ह प्रोपोगेशन इन रोजेस. व्हेजिटेटिव्ह प्रोपोगेशन बाय स्टेम कटिंग. रोज रूट स्टॉक्स आर जनरली प्रोपोगेटेड फ्रॉम मॅच्युअर्ड स्टेम कटिंग. इट इज द चीपेस्ट मेथड ऑफ प्रोपोगेशन ऑफ रोज. दिस मेथड इज पर्टिक्युलरली अडॅप्टेड फॉर मल्टीप्लाइंग मिनिएचर पॉलिएंथा, क्लाइंबर अँड रॅम्बलर रोजेस. सेकंड, टी बडिंग. इन दिस मेथड ऑफ प्रोपोगेशन डिटॅच्ड बर्ड फ्रॉम द सिलेक्टेड रोज व्हरायटी इज इन्सर्टेड इन टू सिलेक्टेड रूट स्टॉक. टी बडिंग इज द मोस्ट वाईडली एक्सेप्टेड मेथड फॉर प्रोपोगेटिंग ऑर्नामेंटल रोज प्लांट्स. द कॅम्बियम लेअर ऑफ द ग्रोईंग लेअर विच इज फाउंड बिटवीन द वूड अँड द बार्क ऑफ द शूट. द सक्सेस ऑफ बडिंग मेनली डिपेंड्स अपॉन जॉइनिंग द कॅम्बियम ऑफ द रूट स्टॉक अँड दॅट ऑफ द बर्ड. स्टेंटिंग. स्टेंटिंग इज द मेथड फॉर क्विक प्रोपोगेशन ऑफ रोजेस. अ पीस ऑफ द स्टेम ऑफ द कल्टिवर विथ वन डॉर्मंट बर्ड इज ग्राफ्टेड ऑन अ रूट स्टॉक. इन स्टेंटिंग बर्ड ऑर ग्राफ्ट युनियन फॉर्मेशन अँड अ ॲडव्हान्टेजियस रूट ऑकर सायमल्टेनियसली रिझल्टिंग इन अ कम्प्लीट प्लांट इन 2 to 3 months. प्लांटिंग. रोजेस कॅन बी प्लांटेड ॲट एनी टाईम ऑफ द इयर. हवेवर इरिस्पेक्टिव्ह ऑफ द लोकेशन्स इन हिल्स, ऑक्टोबर इज द मोस्ट सुटेबल टाईम फॉर प्लांटिंग ऑफ रोजेस. इन अ टेम्परेट क्लायमेट इट कॅन बी प्लांटेड इन द ओपन फील्ड फ्रॉम ऑक्टोबर टू नोव्हेंबर अँड जनवरी टू मार्च. रोज प्लांट्स आर बेस्ट प्लांटेड इन रोज. टू गेट मॅक्झिमम फ्लावरिंग शूट्स रोजेस शुड बी प्रेफरेबली बी प्लांटेड अ स्पेसिंग ऑफ 20 to 25 centimeters from plant to plant and 50 centimeters row to row within beds may be required for hybrid teas and floribundas. Roses should be planted on thoroughly prepared pits in beds. Before the operation of planting, this should be ensured that the soil just moist in beds. The depth of the planting will vary with the type of planting materials. The budded plants are planted in such a way that the budding or matrix point should remain 5 to 7 centimeters above the soil surface. Irrigation. Roses are very fond of water and require 1 to 2 inches of it every week. During the hot dry season, even more may be needed depending upon the size of bush. In spite of their need for an abundance of water, roses hate standing in water and provision for proper drainage is essential. Irrigation should be done during the morning time. Avoid evening watering, which should foster powdery mildew, which is the very common disease among roses. During the rainy season, watering will be required only during dry periods. Pruning. Pruning is the most important operation in rose cultivation, which influences the yield and quality of flowers. In pruning, all dry, diseased, weak and crisscross shoots are removed to open up the center of the bush. Any suckers that arises from the rootstock are also removed. The best time of pruning is during the period when the rose plant is at dormant or near to dormant stage. It will depend upon the climatic conditions of the rose growing region. Usually, the hybrid tea and the floribunda roses take 45 to 50 days to come to flowering after the pruning. In plains, prune is recommended on 15th October to 15th November. In hilly areas where the winter is very cold, the pruning operation is done in the first week of February to 15th March. Nutrition. Rose is heavy feeder crop and it requires regular feeding of nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium in large quantities. When nitrogen is deficient, the young leaves become small in size, develop pale green color with yellow and red tints, and the buds develop poorly and they are light in color. A high nitrogen dose is more effective for increasing stem length, flower yield and quality of flower. Phosphorus is important for encouraging root growth and stimulating flowering. It can be applied in the form of superphosphate and phosphoric acid. Its deficiency symptoms in rose are blue-green or dark green leaves, weak stem and slow bud development due to poor roots. Potassium is responsible for hardness of the flower stem, better quality of bloom and increased resistance to diseases. Due to potassium deficiency, lower leaves show browning and stem become weak and color of the flower get poorer. In manual fertilizer application, nitrogen in combination with phosphorus and potassium, 9 gram nitrogen plus 8 gram phosphorus plus 8 gram potassium per meter square per week is recommended for flower yield and quality. Foliar spray of micronutrient is more effective in roses. It is recommended that 3 gram each of magnesium sulfate and potassium sulfate along with 0.75 gram borax dissolved in 1 liter of water and spread on roots corrected the deficiency of magnesium, potassium and boron. Weeding and hoeing. Weeding, if neglected, may cause a setback in flower yield and quality. Manual weeding is the most prevalent practice. Hoeing of rose bed at fortnight interval is helpful in removing weeds and loosening soil for better aeration and improving soil moisture retention capacity. Shallow hoeing is preferred as deep hoeing destroys the fibrous roots. Mulching. Mulching reduces weed infestation and promotes the economy of irrigation water. Various materials such as dry plant leaves and paddy straw, etc. can be used for mulching. About 6 to 8 cm mulch of dried leaves in rose bed in the month of April does not allow any weeds for about 2 months, that is in May and June, and reduces their reappearance in following months. Pinching. Removal of a part of a terminal growing region of a shoot is known as pinching, and it is an important operation in rose cultivation. After every blush, minor pinching is done for succeeding return crop and for adjusting flowering for specific timing. Pinching reduces plant height and increases new axillary branching. It should be carried out above 3 leaflets in weak and 5 leaflets in healthy shoots. Disbudding and disuckering. Disbudding of axillary buds in hybrid tea and floribunda roses are beneficial for increasing the size of the flower. The suckering appearing from the rootstock should be removed periodically from the point of origin. Insect and pest of roses. Red spider mite. Mites are very common on roses. They first appear on lower surface of the leaves and can subsequently cover the entire leaf, stem and after some time the whole plant with their web. The infected plant given dusty and webbed appearance. These can be controlled by spraying kelthane at 0.1% or omite at 0.03%. Caterpillars. Caterpillars are the mostly a problem of rose buds and young leaves. In the initial stage, they eat away the foliage. The eggs are laid down on the buds and the larvae eat into the bud, damaging it completely. Caterpillars can be controlled by spraying Nuvan at 0.15 to 0.2%. Aphids. Aphids occur in more than 400 aphis species. Many are vectors for a number of viruses. Aphids are sucking insects They draw chlorophylls from leaves and buds. It is recommended to spray off Metasystox or Melathion at 0.2% to control aphids. Thrips. Among insects, thrips are the most serious pest on rose. Thrips prefers dry hot conditions. Both nymphs and adult forms of this small insect and suck the cell sap from the leaves, tender stem and flowers. It is recommended the application of dimethoate and monocrotophos at 0.05 to 0.1% to control thrips. Red scale. Red scale insect attack on the lower part of the old stem of rose and cover them with the reddish brown waxy incrustation. The scale insect suck the plant sap and the infested stem gradually dries up. Rainy season is the main period for the infestation of red scale insect on the rose plant. These insects can be removed by rubbing the infested stem with old soft toothbrush. This can be controlled by spraying monocrotophos at 0.1 to 0.15%. Diseases of roses. Dieback. The severity of the disease is noticed after the pruning operation. As the name indicates, symptoms of this disease are blackening at the tip of the stem, which spreads downward rapidly. The disease can be prevented by taking precaution at the time of pruning. The pruning cut should be slanted and made with sharp cicatrice. Some systemic fungicides like bivisting 0.2% should be sprayed immediately after pruning. Removal of infected part, including about 2 to 3 cm below in the healthy part, and use of bivisting paste afterwards control the disease. Powdery mildew. In powdery mildew, initially whitish tiny spots appear on the young leaves. The entire plant displays white powdery appearance in severe cases, consequently reducing the vigor of the plant. Infected buds do not open, and open in flowers, the infection leads to discoloration. The disease can be controlled by carathin at 0.1% or benlate at 0.1%. Downy mildew. Downy mildew is a very common disease of rose and occur under moist, cloudy conditions. All species of cultivated and wild roses seems to be susceptible. Under cold and moist spring conditions, young leaves, stem and flowers may manifest purple to red or brown irregular spots. As the disease advances, lesions on the leaves become angular and black with the possible appearance of white mycelium on the underside of the leaf. The disease can be controlled by spraying rhodomyl or diethane M45 at 0.2%. Black spot. This fungal disease causes major problem. The infested leaf shows black spot on the upper and lower side. At latter stages, leaves become yellow and fall off. The disease can be controlled by spraying diethane M45 at 0.15%. It is also advised to have minor pruning if required. During rainy season, if there is overgrowth, including removal of minor and diseased shoots. Flower harvesting and post-harvest management. The flowers are harvested when they are at tight bud stage and when petals have just started unfolding. It should be harvested either in the morning or evening by sharp cicatrice. After harvesting, flowers should be dipped in clean water. To store cut flowers, it is recommended to place them in good quality water at 2 to 4 degrees Celsius temperature. Approximately in hybrid tea and floribunda roses, 150 to 250 and 250 to 300 flowering shoots per square meter per year respectively, a reasonable expectation from polyhouse grown roses. Marketing of roses. Rose market is both for cut flowers for decorative purpose and for scented rose petals, for rose oil, rose water and for gulkan. Rose flower demand is high in the marriage season and in festivals, mostly in January to May and August to December. Hyderabad, Mumbai, Delhi, Ahmedabad, Kolkata, Pune, Bangalore are the major markets for rose flower. Importance of roses. Rose oil. It is obtained from rose petals. It is having sweet fragrance and medicinal properties. Gulkand. Rose petals are also preserved for direct consumption, prepared by taking equal proportion of petals and sugar. It is considered as tonic and laxative. Rose water. Rose water is important commercial product obtained from rose petals, used as perfume, medicine and confectionery. It cools the body, used in eye lotions, eye drops for its soothing quality. Pankhuri. Dried rose petals are known as pankhuri. They are occasionally used for preparing sweetened cold drinks. This is all about cultivation of roses. Hope you will understand the concept.